What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. I'm at the Waldorf Astoria Shanghai on the Bund right here. And today, after about a week of exiting quarantine here in Shanghai, I'm finally going back to Beijing and I'll be taking business class on high-speed rail. Our journey today begins at the business class channel at Shanghai Hongqiao Railway Station, where we breezed past the crowd of people and made our way through within a few minutes. Okay, we've made it through security, and now let's go look for the business class lounge. It's interesting because with high-speed rail, business class is actually the highest level of service. It's above what's known as first class, which is also above what's known as second class. So I'm really interested to see how the experience compares to getting on business class on a plane, and in particular, what kind of food I get, what kind of drinks I get, what kind of seats I get on the business class high-speed rail. But in terms of the lounge experience, I would say that we're not off to a great start because there's no hot food here. So I'm gonna go upstairs and get some real food. As a business class passenger, I got to use a special boarding channel, once again bypassing the throngs of people who are booked in first and second class. Business class on these flagship routes consists of 17 seats distributed across 7 rows in a 1-1 or 2-1 configuration. The main cabin has 5 rows, and then there's a galley with a toilet and a sink. And then after that, at the very end of the train, is a mini cabin that has 2 rows of 5 seats in total. I've just sat down in business class on high-speed rail. It's pretty incredible. Let's take a look around. On this trip, I was assigned seat 3A, a solo seat on the left side of the cabin. Let's go for a seat tour. Over on the left armrest, you have a little storage space just underneath the flap here. And then there's the power outlet and USB outlet facing the front. Over on the right side, you've got your seat controls, which allow you to move your seat into lie-flat mode. And then there's also the tray table, which is extracted from this flap over here. Up top, you've got a set of 2 coat hooks, and there's also a foot rest that you can fold outwards to rest your feet. The tray table itself is kind of like what you'll find on airplane business class. It slides outwards and folds outwards like so. I thought it was pretty sturdy, but the size was pretty small, and it was kind of difficult to eat and work from it. Then you've got a reading light on the side, as well as these blinds that you can slide downwards to block out the windows. The crew began the in-train service with a cup of tea and some snacks, although they wouldn't return with the food until later on. I decided to check out the bathrooms, which were kept in a very clean condition throughout the train ride, certainly cleaner than over in first class and second class. Now, outside of the bathroom itself, you've got the sink opposite it, you've got a place to collect hot water, and the rest of the galley is for getting on and off the train, or for looking at the views of the countryside and the cityscapes, speeding by. Soon I headed back to my seat, where it was time to have a rest. Now this bed is just about long enough to fit my frame of 180 centimeters and yeah, just about comfortable enough for a nap during the daytime. After napping for an hour or so, I decided to get some work done and it was nice to be able to connect to the free Wi-Fi while I worked. And about an hour and a half before our arrival in Beijing, dinner was served, consisting of a meal box and a bowl of soup. Honestly, this kind of reminds me of the food from my 14-day quarantine period. It's definitely not as good as airplane business class, but it's still pretty tasty. After dinner is when we achieved our top speed of almost 350 kilometers an hour as we sped towards Beijing South Railway Station. All right, we're gonna go check out first class and second class just to see what it's like. The first class configuration on the high-speed trains has 4 seats per row. It's still fairly comfortable, although certainly not quite as luxurious as business class, whereas second class has 5 seats per row and tends to get pretty tight. Each cabin car also consists of the toilet and sink arrangement as before. After briefly going to explore, I of course decided to come back to business class to finish off the journey. And as we pulled into the city limits and the buildings began to look ever more familiar, it was nice to look back on the journey so far. 14 days of quarantine, 7 days spent around Shanghai, and this luxurious business class journey as I finally arrived home. With that, high-speed rail business class is checked off the bucket list. I've made it back home here in Beijing, and I'm really excited to have finally completed high-speed rail business class here in China. I've done second class and first class a couple times before on the trains, but this was my first time in the fancy seats. To be honest, business class on high-speed rail is definitely a bit of a splurge, just like business class on an airplane. However, the overall quality of the product is probably still a little bit below what you'll get on an airplane just in terms of the food and the service. However, there is still that lie-flat seat that you can enjoy and take a nap in as you travel from one place to another. If I'm being honest, I think the speed and convenience of high-speed rail is definitely the more exciting part compared to the product itself. I mean, the fact that we can travel from Shanghai to Beijing in about 5 hours' time is pretty incredible, and I would love to see something like high-speed rail being introduced in Canada along the Toronto-Montreal or Toronto-Vancouver corridors at some point in the future. For me personally, now that I've checked off high-speed rail business class off my bucket list, I'll probably continue booking second class and first class tickets on my China high-speed rail journeys going forward because it's more reasonably priced at around 100 to 150 Canadian dollars one way for, let's say, the Shanghai-Beijing journey, as compared to about 400 Canadian dollars for that high-speed rail business class journey that you just saw. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed coming along for the experience. Stay tuned for more travel content and more travel tips here on this channel, and I'll see you in the next video.
Mm-hmm.